Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra. And here in Shiksha Mantra today, we'll discuss something that will be of much use for our students. Most of the times, when we learn English grammar, we make so very different ideas, so very different convictions that sometimes they get troublesome for us. If I ask you a question, a very simple question, I play with a ball. This is my sentence. I play with a ball. Now, I ask you, tell me, what's the tense of this sentence? Sometimes you'll get some noise in the background, some bursting noise. Just ignore them. Because people are so very entertaining. They're enjoying themselves by bursting crackers without considering about the laws, etc., etc. Just let it be as a background music. Rather focus what we are discussing. So I play with a ball. I play with a ball. Now here in this sentence, if I ask you which tense does it belong, most of the cases, for most of the students, the answer I get is the sentence belong to present tense. So that's the answer. Now if you ask me, sir, are they right or wrong? I'll say no, they are wrong. Present, it's not a tense. Present is only a time. I haven't asked you about the time of the sentence. I have asked you about the tense of the sentence. Now, sir, we got confused. Most of the time in many books, we have found out that tense, these are of three types, present tense, past tense, future tense, and now you are saying these are not tenses, rather these are times. So how is it? It's very confusing. It's not confusing at all, my dear friends. Remember, when we talk of time, these are of three kinds. So what are they? First, we get present. So this is the first time. Present time, then we get the second one, and as you know it, we get past time, and then we get the third one, and as you know it, it's future time. So we get present time, past time, and future time. These are but time. Now what are the tenses? Actually, each and every time is again divided into four parts, and these are called the aspects. So we get simple aspects, then we get second, that is the continuous aspect. Third, we get perfect aspect, and the fourth, we get what? Yes, you know it. We get perfect continuous. Though it's to make the discussion very easy, I'm making it like this. I'm using four aspects. Though in grammar, in proper grammatical discussions, you won't get four aspects. That's also something we must remember, we must learn it, or there will be some confusions. When you are there in conventional grammar and you will discuss about it, obviously you won't get aspects of four different kinds, and don't get confused that we haven't taught, sir has taught us that we have four different aspects, but there in the grammar book we haven't found out four different aspects. So what is it? It's to make the discussion easy. Then we will discuss what is aspect and how it forms in the discussion of modern English grammar, in learning of tenses. We'll get to everything. But before learn, before going to this part, just learn what are the aspects. Just to make it easy, I'm discussing that there are four different aspects. Actually, these aspects belong to these times. And together, what is tense? Let us make it very simple and very effective. Let us produce a formula. Tense is but time plus aspect. That is the tense. Time plus aspect. How it is? When you say time present and with the time you add aspect, indefinite or simple, whatever you may consider it, indefinite or simple, you get the tense. And what's the tense now? The tense is simple present or present indefinite. And suppose here you have taken the time as past and you have considered the aspect. You have found out that the aspect used here is continuous. So what you get? You get the tense past continuous. So that's how tense means time plus aspect. So whenever you are asked about the tense of a sentence, just remember, dear students, most of the time you make this mistake. What you do, you consider this as only the time and not the tense. But it mustn't be done. First, you have to check the verb and then the form of the verb, and you will get which tense is it belonged to. So here first you have to use the aspect and the time together to get the tense of a sentence. That's it. That is what we will learn here. That's what our discussion here in Shiksha Mantra today. We must tell the tense of a sentence and not its time, because most of the time we have found that you tell the time only and not the tense. So that's it. I think it will be of much helpful. Obviously, Shiksha Mantra has present Sham Shiksha, and it will help you to learn your tense and to proceed further. Obviously, we'll discuss more about it. And it's all for today. We are returning very soon. Till then, bye bye. Happy learning.